In crisis in the classroom, experts warn the fallout from COVID-related school shutdowns is unfortunately about to get worse.
Chris Papps has been investigating public education for almost 5 years now, and tonight he explains why too many students have suffered learning loss and the impact for years to come.
Project Baltimore broke the news last summer. 41% of all Baltimore City high school students earned below a 1.0 grade point average, less than a D, in the first three quarters of last school year, up from 24% before the COVID shutdowns. Experts refer to this as learning loss.
This is really disheartening. This is a real crisis. A crisis that needs outside-of-the-box thinking.
Now, a new study from the World Bank shows learning loss globally will likely translate into earning loss for students affected. The World Bank calls learning loss from COVID shutdowns morally unacceptable, saying it's become an education crisis.
The study estimates this current generation of students globally could lose upwards of $17 trillion in lifetime earnings. The World Bank directly blames the learning loss on the school shutdowns due to COVID-19. And that $17 trillion figure is up from an estimated $10 trillion in 2020. So why is the number going up? Because even today, many students are still not in the classroom full time.
I think it's as accurate as can be.
Inaban Basu,
I think it's devastating,
is an economist with Sage Policy Group and a former member of the Baltimore City School Board.
So they haven't learned a year's worth of content in a year. They've learned much less than that. They've fallen behind.
Over the last 30 years, Basu says the world has made enormous progress in lowering poverty rates. And that was done, he says, through improving the quality of education around the world. But now, the COVID shutdowns have set everyone back, including Americans. And he believes unless school students can catch up, the losses can last a lifetime.
We know there's a positive correlation between knowledge and earnings. We know there's a positive correlation between educational attainment and earnings.
The solution, according to Basu, is not easy, but necessary. He says even as COVID spreads, kids need to be in school. They need to be learning. They need to catch up. After school, summer programs, whatever it takes. Further shutdowns, he says, will only lead to students falling further behind, especially those students from lower income areas, which tend to have less support and resources at home.
These kids, that's who we have to focus on. They're the most vulnerable. It's hard. But we need to do it. Otherwise, they face a life of ill fortune economically, at least potentially, of dislocation. And when you have a lot of people who are unemployed in a society, who don't have a place in society, that leads to very bad social outcomes.
In Baltimore, I'm Chris Pabst.